Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Joseph Ward, your historical homeboy, right here on the On the Shoulders of Giants YouTube channel. Thank you for tuning in, for checking me out, and being a part of this journey. We're here to give you the sung and unsung heroes of the African diaspora that you probably wouldn't learn about. So thank you for rocking with us. And I just want to let you know that we're now on Patreon. So you can become a patron and help us empower and educate as many communities as possible throughout the African diaspora. www.patreon.com/OTSOG. Now go ahead and get to this video so we can drop this knowledge on you. Peace out. Alexandre Dumas. On July 24, 1802, Dumas David de la Pailleterie was born in Villers-Cotterêts, France, to parents Thomas Alexandre Dumas and Marie-Louise Elizabeth Labouret. Thomas Alexandre was the son of a French nobleman and an African woman enslaved in Haiti. Dumas began his writing career in 1822 after moving to Paris, France. He became the scribe for the Duke of Orleans, Louis Philippe, during the Revolution of 1830. While working for Louis Philippe, he also began writing his own magazine articles and plays. In 1829, at the age of 27, he produced his first play, Henry III and His Courts. His play was well received and critically acclaimed by his audience and critics. In 1830, he produced his second play, Christine, which was also met with critical acclaim and allowed him to make money as a writer. Dumas followed in the footsteps of his grandmother and father by changing his last name from De La Pailleterie to Dumas to connect more with his family's African roots. Following his success as a playwright, Dumas began writing novels, essays, and short stories surrounding the topics of crime and humiliations and became known as a serial novelist. In 1838, Dumas published his first novel, Le Capitaine Paul, which was a reworking of one of his plays. He also created a production studio to help him write many more novels. Celebrated Crimes is an 8-volume essay collection written by Dumas and others between 1839 and 1841. The novel, The Fencing Master, was published in 1840. And highlighted the fencing master Augustin Grisier and what he witnessed during the Russian December's revolt. Because of the content and popularity of the fencing master, Dumas was banned, and the fencing master was outlawed by then Tsar Nicholas I. In 1844, Dumas published some of his most famous works, The Count of Monte Cristo, The Corsican Brothers, and The Three Musketeers. In 1843, Dumas published the novel Georges to address the many issues associated with his African heritage. Dumas became knowledgeable of his African ancestry and was proud of who he was. The popularity of his novels led them to being translated into different languages and mountains of money coming in. He was able to support his lifestyle, which was said to include many women and much spending. His homes, Le Port Marly and Chateau de Monte Cristo, were examples of his opulent lifestyle and gregarious nature. The downside to the way he lived was he spent a lot of his money entertaining people. When financial troubles arose, he was forced to sell his properties and his friends were nowhere to be found. Soon Napoleon Bonaparte came to power in France and was not fond of Dumas' writings. By the time Dumas published his widely read travel books, Dumas left France in 1851 for Brussels, Belgium, before moving to Russia in 1859. Some people say Dumas escaping from creditors was part of the reason he left France. Because the Russian elite spoke French as a second language, Dumas was able to continue earning money from his many writings. It is believed that Dumas wrote over 100,000 pages in his life. In 1861, Dumas traveled to Italy after Victor Emmanuel II became the King of Italy. Dumas became involved in the unification of Italy and founded the newspaper The Independent before returning to France in 1864. Alexandre Dumas died in 1870 and was buried in his hometown as a literary giant who at the time was being overshadowed by the political climate in Europe. Over time, his contributions to literature became greatly appreciated by the world. The Alexandre Dumas Paris Metro was named to honor his works in 1970, along with the restoration of his home, the Chateau de Monte Cristo. Over his lifetime, Dumas wrote 28 high adventure fiction works, 3 D'Artagnan romances, 7 Villot romances, 8 Marie Antoinette romances, and 3 entries in the Saint-Germain trilogy. He also wrote 5 dramas to round off his long list of fictional works, writings that further helped him to cement himself as an iconic writer. As far as non-fictional works, Dumas wrote over 13 non-fiction books, which included his numerous travel novels. Dumas is best known for writing the books The Three Musketeers and The Count of Monte Cristo. But as we have learned, his literary contribution was vast, and this came from a man of African ancestry. I make that last statement because it was and still is believed that people of African descent are inferior to Europeans. But from my studies, I have learned that Europe and all other Western nations would be nothing without black people. Dumas was second to none as a writer, and his writings have stood the test of time on an international stage. Dumas, Davy de la Pailleterie, aka Alexandre Dumas, we proudly stand on your shoulders. For more information, please visit www.ontheshoulders1.com or www.ontheshoulders.org. And you can learn more about the On the Shoulders of Giants book series by visiting my website. And also, you can support On the Shoulders of Giants on Patreon by going to patreon.com/OTSOG.